After every Islamic terrorist attack, like the one happened to Hatun Tash, we have three reactions. First is the unapologetic. Terrorist attacks are Islamically justified. Secondly is the whitewash. Nothing to do with Islam. All religions are the same. Downgrade the severity of Islamic terrorism as a social phenomenon. Victim blaming. And three, we have the true one, the true narrative. Islamic terrorism is a distinct social phenomenon derived from the philosophical codifications of Islamic ideology. The only way to stop Islamic terrorism is to tackle Islamic doctrines and teachings that create Islamic terrorism. Notice, from the three of them, the first is true, the unapologetic, and the third one is true. The second one is not true. Okay, so from the three narratives, the first and the third are true. The second one is not true. Yet, Muslim apologists in the West go with a second narrative, the whitewash. Nothing to do with Islam. All religions are the same, are equal. Downgrade the severity of Islamic terrorism as a social phenomenon and victim blaming. Let's see if Islamic Defense will sway away from the second narrative.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to another episode of the Islamic Defense Podcast. So a few days ago, I heard the news that Hatun from Seeker's Corner was apparently stabbed. And she's basically a Christian apologist and she's very infamous for her Islamophobia.
Apparently stabbed. What a weird description of this action.
But when I slow down the video, you can see the knife as it slashes Hatun in the face. And this guy just keeps stabbing and slashing her in the name of Allah for the sake of his false prophet. He's aiming for her neck. Why? Because the Quran says, smite at their necks.
Can we say that he just misspoke? Or maybe he's downgrading the severity of Islamic terrorism as a social phenomenon? I mean, how on earth do you make this kind of mistake? Apparently, using this word, apparently stabbed. Even if you were referring to, I heard the news, she was apparently stabbed. This kind of words, what apparently stabbed? She was stabbed. Blood was running through her face. What I'm trying to say, guys, is that if I made a YouTube video and I said, by mistake, apparently stabbed, I would have took down my video and corrected that. It's outrageous to say apparently. It's outrageous, okay? So it's not like a mistake.
So a few days ago, I heard the news that Hatun from Seeker's Corner was apparently stabbed. And she's basically a Christian apologist and she's very infamous for her Islamophobia.
So, in the same sentence, you say apparently stabbed, you continue saying she was an Islamophobe. No, the correct way you should have said this is, once again, it was proven that what Hatun says about Islam is absolutely true. She's not an Islamophobe. She simply says the truth about Islam, as it was demonstrated once again.